Hello friends, welcome to this episode of Science for Common Man. The average surface temperature of Earth is plus 14 degrees Celsius. Can you imagine an Earth with an average surface temperature of minus 18 degrees Celsius instead of the present plus 14 degree? An Earth full of ice without any flowing water bodies. Well, it would have been the case if we did not have so-called greenhouse effect in our atmosphere. So today's question is, what is greenhouse effect? Which gases are responsible for it and why those alone? Let's find it out. And as usual, this explanation will be from the basics and comprehensive. During day, when sunlight falls on the Earth, surface of Earth gets heated and temperature of Earth's surface increases. Now listen, any body whose temperature is higher will radiate heat to outside and try to reduce its temperature. This is why we feel hot while standing near fire or a red hot heater coil. So the hot surface of Earth radiates heat to outside and thereby tries to reduce the temperature. But around 90% of this heat radiated out from the Earth is absorbed by some gases present in the atmosphere, and a part of this is re-radiated to Earth, and thus this heat is trapped in the Earth. This trapping of heat prevents Earth from losing heat and reducing temperature, and Earth remains warm. This is called greenhouse effect. The gases which block this escaping heat are water vapor, carbon dioxide, methane, etc. and they are called greenhouse gases. Now we have two questions. First one, why these gases are not absorbing incoming light from sun? Second one, Earth's atmosphere has 78% nitrogen and 21% oxygen. All the greenhouse gases make up only around 1%. Why nitrogen and oxygen do not absorb these radiations and why they do not cause greenhouse effect? About the first point, if the greenhouse gases absorb the radiation emitted by the Earth's surface and do not absorb the light or radiation coming from sun, then there should be some difference between the two radiations. What is that? Second point, nitrogen does not absorb this radiation while carbon dioxide does. So there should be a difference in the way these gases behave to this radiation. What is that? First, let's look closely into the incoming radiation and outgoing radiation to find out the difference. Well, as we look closer, we can understand that these radiations are made up of oscillating electric and magnetic fields. And see, there is a difference in the rate and length of oscillation between the two, and except these, everything looks same. The number of oscillations in 1 second, or so-called frequency, is higher by around 10 times in the incoming one compared to the outgoing one. So now we have two cases. One, incoming radiation which is oscillating at higher rate and neither nitrogen nor carbon dioxide absorbs it. Second, outgoing radiation from Earth at around 1/10th rate, and now suddenly carbon dioxide can absorb it but nitrogen still cannot absorb it. That means there should be something special with carbon dioxide compared to nitrogen. To find it, let us study the structure of carbon dioxide further. If we carefully see, this kind of a vibration or oscillation is possible for carbon dioxide because of its structure. And in carbon dioxide molecule, there is a negative charge concentration on oxygen atoms which is balanced during normal state since they are perfectly on opposite sides. But during this kind of a vibration, the charge separation happens and unbalance occurs as we see. And the frequency of the oscillation, or the number of cycles per second, is dependent on the characteristics of the bond between the atoms, mass, and the distribution of atoms in the molecule. It so happens for carbon dioxide that the frequency of this oscillation is matching with that of radiation emitted by Earth, and there is a charge separation that happens in carbon dioxide during this oscillation in the same frequency as that of radiation, which can interact with the oscillating electric field of the radiation. These make it possible for carbon dioxide to react to radiation. This type of interaction between matching frequencies is called resonance. And as a result, carbon dioxide absorbs the radiation of that frequency and begins to vibrate in the same frequency. Once the energy is absorbed by carbon dioxide, it imparts this energy to the surrounding molecules, and the overall energy, or in the case of a gas, temperature, increases. And thus, radiation emitted by the Earth is absorbed by the greenhouse gases and in turn increases the temperature of atmosphere. Since molecules like nitrogen, oxygen, etc., which have only two identical atoms, do not have this mode of vibration and charge separation. They cannot absorb this and cannot be termed as greenhouse gases. Gases like water vapor, methane, etc. have these vibrational modes, and they also can absorb energy like this and can contribute to greenhouse effect. The percentage of contribution of individual gases is like this. If we did not have this greenhouse effect, Earth would have been much cooler, in fact frozen, with an average surface temperature of minus 18 degrees Celsius. So, greenhouse effect plays an important role in making Earth a livable planet. Thank you for watching. Hope you liked it. Do support and subscribe to us and click the bell button to receive notifications about the future videos. Signing off, Science for Common Man.